फ्रेंड्स, डू यू फाइंड योर सेल्फ स्ट्रेस्ड आउट बिकॉज यू कैंट मेमोराइज अ वास्ट क्वान्टिटी ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम? बट नाउ डोंट वरी, बिकॉज इन आर टूडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम इफेक्टिव स्टडी टेक्निक्स विच विल हेल्प यू अ लॉट इन योर स्टडीज. सो नाउ लेट्स सी वन बाय वन द मोस्ट पावरफुल स्टडी टेक्निक्स. सो आर फर्स्ट मेथड इज द SQ3R मेथड. सो बेसिकली द SQ3R मेथड इज अ रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशन टेक्निक दैट हेल्प स्टूडेंट्स आइडेंटिफाई इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स एंड रिटेन इन्फॉर्मेशन विद इन द टेक्स्ट बुक. SQ3R जनरली रेफर्स टू सर्वे, क्वेश्चन, रीड, रिसाइट एंड रिव्यू. Before studying anything, just try to do a small survey. Instead of reading the entire book, start by skimming the first chapter and taking notes on any headings, subheadings, images or other standout features like charts. Second step is about question. Try to formulate questions around the chapter's content, such as what is this chapter about? What do I already know about this subject? Then begin reading the full chapter and look for answers to the questions you formulated. Now, after reading a section, summarize in your own words what you just read. Try recalling and identifying major points and answering any questions from the second step. And once you have finished the chapter, it's important to review the material to fully understand it. Quiz yourself on the questions you created and reread any portions you need to. Now, our second most powerful study technique is retrieval practice. Retrieval practice is based on the concept of remembering at a later time. Recalling an answer to a question improves learning more than looking for the answer in your textbook. Remember, if you practice retrieval, you are more likely to remember the information later on. Our next technique is the Feynman technique. It is an efficient method of learning a concept quickly by explaining it in plain and simple terms. Now let's see how this technique actually works. So first of all, write the subject or concept you are studying at the top of a sheet of a paper. Then explain it in your own words as if you were teaching someone else. Now review what you wrote and identify any areas where you were wrong. Once you have identified them, go back to your notes or reading material and figure out the correct answer. Lastly, if there are any areas in your writing where you used technical terms or complex language, go back and rewrite these sections in simpler terms for someone who doesn't have the educational background you have. Our next powerful technique is color-coded notes. Messy notes can make it hard to recall the important points of a lecture. So writing in color is a dynamic way to organize the information you are learning. It also helps you to review and prioritize the most important ideas. Our next most powerful study technique is mind mapping. If you are a visual learner, try mind mapping, a technique that allows you to visually organize information in a diagram. First, you write a word in the center of a blank page. From there, you write major ideas and keywords and connect them directly to the central concept. Other related ideas will continue to branch out. So friends, these were some of the most powerful study techniques. I hope you guys find this information useful. Kindly don't forget to like, subscribe and get notified for my upcoming videos. Thank you for watching the video.